I'm gonna be a cheerleader.
Absolutely not. You will not be a cheerleader.
Why? You were.
You're not cheerleader material like I was.
A fat.
It doesn't look like you had any fun at all making this film.
I know. It was just a bore. No, it was the best.
The two of you have so much chemistry, just even here and, you know, on screen, because you created this for her. And, you know, you must have had your reasons why. Was it an intuitive sort of knowledge that she would work?
Well, we didn't create the role for her. We had to find her. So.
And you were hiding in Peterborough?
Well, I was actually at Etobicoke. I live in Toronto now. I'm from Peterborough.
Oh, okay.
But I'm based here in Toronto.
Well, I'm just striking right out here.
That's okay.
So tell me, all right, so you had this very specific character in mind.
Mm-hmm.
So how were you able to find the perfect girl?
It was hard. We actually pushed the shoot, I think, 3 times because we couldn't find Irene. We looked all across Canada, ended up having to get a U.S. casting director to find somebody in the U.S., and we were going to, like, fly them in and shoot, which complicates things in a Canadian film, but then we found her through our American casting director, and it turns out she was from Etobicoke, and it was just like, how does that work? You know, you have to hire an American to find your neighbor.
Yeah, isn't
that's
that
what
funny?
Happened.
That's
yeah.
So great. And of course, you shoot in The Hammer, and I must say that I spent quite a bit of time trying to figure out where you were shooting. So I was relieved when I had my answer. So that's good.
You saw the smoke stacks in the background. Oh, it's The Hammer.
Yeah, right. No, because you call it The Hammer in the credits. Hamilton,
oh,
The
we
Hammer.
Do.
On
oh, yeah. I noticed that. That was really cool.
Yes. So now your character is, she's sort of bullied, but she's a very spirited person. And she gets into trouble and she's sent to a nursing home. And then her life opens up. So how do you see her as responding to this change in her life, as allowing her to come out?
You know, I think being in that nursing home kind of let her walls come down a little bit, because everyone there was just as innocent in a way as she was. She was able to connect with them. They were put in a place that they necessarily didn't enjoy being, especially Charles. And that's why she really kind of connected with him. And she found that kind of relationship aspect and she just jumped on it. She's like, okay, we're the same in a different kind of way and we can work together and we're gonna be friends and we're gonna have a lot of fun. Let's do this.
So now tell me about how you found her. Obviously you have a script or guidance from Pat, but how did you find Irene in yourself?
There's a lot of similarities between Irene and I. We're both going through weight issues, we're both bullied, and we're both people who are confident in our dreams and want to achieve those goals. And so when I read the script and realized we're kind of like the same person in a different way, it really helped me connect myself to that character, and because I could relate to her, so I could bring out hopefully the best in what she needed to represent.
Right, right. So is there another film set in that world coming along? Because it'd be really nice triumvirate.
Do a little trilogy,
yeah,
of like somebody drinking, yes, somewhere.
You've got to be
more
up
drinking.
A tree in the next chair.
So I'm developing a limited TV series right now. It would be similar, but it might be a bit more grounded in reality. But that's what the next thing on my plate is.
Really?
Yeah, so hopefully people are interested enough in it to help me get made. It's based on my experiences in grade 9, and I had moved to Toronto from another city. I didn't know anybody. I had long blonde hair. My name is Pat, and everyone had assumed that I was a girl. And so I know what it's like to be a teenage girl.
Yeah.
I was treated like one because everybody assumed I was one. So it's exploring gender identity.
That sounds fantastic.
Thanks.
It really, really does.
People
we can
like
all relate
it so far.
To it in some way. I'm short.
Time is running.
Not die in here. My grandpa was hit by a delivery truck outside of a laundromat.